Hi students, welcome to today's class. Now we are going to discuss about unit 3, that is Python programming, introduction to Python. Okay, so introduction to Python we are going to look at here, and in that chapter 1, that is getting started. In this lesson, what you are going to understand here is, so we will understand the use of graphical user interface and IDLE, that is integrated development environment, for creating the Python programs. So how we can use IDLE shell in order to type the Python programming, and graphical user interface also we will see in that. And next one is working in interactive and script mode for programming. So interactive method of typing program, and script mode we can type the program also. So in both the ways we can type and execute the program, and we can see the result. Okay, so the two methods also we will see, interactive mode of execution and script mode of programming also we will see here. And next one is how to create a variable, and what is the procedure we need to use for creating a variable, or rules what we need to follow for creating a variable or identifying writing an identifier. And then how we can assign the values to those variables also we will see. And we will understand the concept and usage of different data types that are going to be used in Python, because any programming or any mathematical problems, if you want to solve, we need to handle different types of data, either a number, an integer data, or a decimal data, that is floating point numbers also we can make use of. And we will work on strings also, that is group of characters also we will work on. So different types of data we will get as input. So the different types of data types we will study in a Python, and we will understand the importance and usage of different types of operators also. Okay, so because any mathematical operations or comparisons, if it is going to be used in problems, no, mathematical problems, we will go for arithmetical operators, relational operators, and logical operators and all. So different types of operators also you are going to study in this chapter, and then how we can create the expressions. So once you have studied about the different types of data and operators, you can able to create the expressions, Python expressions, and you can create the statements also. Okay, so these are the topics we will see. We are going to study here in this chapter 1, that is getting started. Now we are going to see about introduction. So in order to tell the computer what you want to do, that is we need to say the computer what it should do. Okay, so for that we need to write the program in a language which computer can understand. So we need to, whatever program we are writing in one particular language, that should be understood by the computer. Okay, then only we can get the result from the computer. So though there are many different programming languages are available, like basic means what? Beginner's all purpose symbolic instruction code. So this is the full form of basic. So even if we have a different programming languages like basic, Pascal, C, C++, Java, Haskell, Ruby, Python, etc., we are going to study Python here in this course. So before learning this technicalities of Python, we will get familiar with it. Okay, so we need to know who is the founder of this Python, and when, which year it was found, and how he found, where he found, everything we will see. Why this programming language got its name like Python. So all those things we will see here, and some of the features of this Python also, and applications where it is used popularly, and what is the advantage of this Python, everything we will see here in this introduction part. So Python was created by Guido van Rossum when he was working at CWI, that is the name of the institute is Centrum Discunde Informatica, which is a national research institute for mathematics and computer science. Normally, computer science is a subject which is connected majorly with mathematics subject only. Okay, connected majorly with mathematics subject, because if you want to be a programmer, you need to have a strong mathematical knowledge. Okay, logic and all, if you want to write, convert in a programming code, any mathematical problem, if you solve correctly only, you can able to do the programming. Okay, so the institute where he was working is CWI, that is Centrum Discunde Informatica, which is a national research institute for mathematics and computer science in which country? Netherlands. Okay, so who is the founder of this Python? Guido van Rossum. So the language was released in which year? 1991. Okay, so by Python, how it got its name? It got its name from BBC comedy series from 70s. Okay, that is Monty Python's Flying Circus. From this series only, it got its name as Python. So Python can be used to follow both procedural approach and object-oriented approach. So some programming languages and all follows the procedural approach only. C programming, if you take it, it is follow procedural approach only. C++ will follow object-oriented approach. So here, this Python is going to follow both the approach, that is procedural and object-oriented approach. So both of its benefits are going to be used here in this Python. So it is free to use also. This program, we can Python interpreter or programming languages, we can easily, freely, we can use it. Okay. Some of the features which make the Python so popular are as follows. What are the features it is making the Python as a popular one? So these are the reasons. Okay, the features are, it is a general purpose programming language which can be used for, general purpose means it can be used for both scientific purpose and non-scientific purpose. And then it is a platform independent programming language. That means we can download this Python, we can install in any OS and we can work on it. Okay. Platform in the sense, any OS, this software can be usable. And it is a very simple high-level language. What is meant by high-level? It is a language which is written in English. Okay, so it is a very simple high-level language with vast library of add-on modules. That means many libraries will be there. If you look at our school library or in library, if you see, lot of books will be there with different topics. Similar manner, here in Python programming or any other programming language, if you take header files or library files, we will say. So that library files will include some of the functions, like a math module, if you take. So math module is like a math library. Okay. So in that math module, we will have some of the functions like square root function. Okay. So square root, sine of some number and cosine. And tan, like that, in maths you are studying, no? So that numbers and values, and all easily you can find the answers with the help of using that name of the function itself. Okay, just you pass the name of the function, that is square root. In order to find the square root of any number, like a square root of 25, if you want to find, what is the answer? 5. So for that, sqrt, opening and closing parentheses, inside that you can, inside that opening and closing parentheses, you can pass the value as 25. Okay, so that square root function, where it is located, the task is where it is located, the actually the square root functions, instructions and all, that is programming code for making that code to be workable one, okay, usable one, some programs are written for that square root function, okay, so that is already written by the manufacturer itself. So that code, that is square root of function code, is there in the math module, that is math library. Okay, so you need to import that math module before you use the mathematical functions which are there in that math module. Okay, so for example, sqrt function, if you want to use in the programming, you need to include that math module or math library. So how to include math module in your programming? So for that, we need to study. We are going to study some syntax, how we can import the mathematical modules or some other modules or libraries which are available in the Python programming. Okay, so that is very, very useful if we are adding on the modules. So it is having a lot of modules and the lot of libraries in order to finish our task in a quick way. Okay, so we no need to write the code for finding the square root of any number. Simply, if you pass that function name sqrt of parentheses inside value, you will get the answer. It is excellent for beginners as the language is interpreter. So the Python programming language is the interpreted language. That means line by line it will execute and it is going to display the answer. So if there is any mistake in any line, that is going to be indicated with this Python interpreter with the help of the number. Okay, so the line number also is getting displayed. So line by line it will execute, that is the advantage. So it is excellent for beginners as the language is interpreted one, hence it gives the results immediately, either the positive result or negative result error, it will be showing immediately on the screen. Okay, then the programs written in Python are easily readable and understandable, so we can easily read and understand whatever programs we have written in the Python. It is suitable as an extension language for customizable applications. So it is going to be used as added language, additional language for customizable applications. That means what? Customer oriented any task we want to generate, no, any software we want to generate. So for that purpose, this Python is going to be used as the additional language. Next is, it is easy to learn and use. It is easy to learn and we can use it also. And the language which is used by the companies in real revenue generating products, such as, okay, so which companies and all it is going to be used for a real revenue generating products, like in Google search engine and YouTube and all, in some of the operations they are going they are using this Python programming language. And BitTorrent company, it is a peer-to-peer file sharing company that is written using the Python only. So that is, peer-to-peer file sharing operation is written using the Python only. And then Intel, Cisco, HP, IBM and all famous for manufacturing computer products or electronic products. So that uses Python for hardware testing. So they, if the hardware parts want to be tested, so they are using the Python programming language nowadays. Now Maya provides a Python scripting API interface, application programming interface. Next one is iRobot. It's a company that uses Python to develop the commercial robots. So robots and all, we want to develop, you know, commercial purposes, we can make use of this Python programming language. And then NASA and others uses Python for their scientific programming task. So next we are going to see the first step with Python. So before we start typing any coding in the Python, we need to understand where we need to type and how it is going to be executed. So, and from where we can download the interpreter also, that we will see here. We are continuously saying that Python is a programming language, but we don't know what a program is. Okay, so therefore let's start Python by understanding the program. What is meant by program? Program is a sequence of instructions that is specifying how to perform a computation. So it will specify us how to perform a calculation or computation. The computation might be mathematical or working with the text. So it can be working on some numbers or maybe working on with the text also. So whenever we write a program, that program will work on either numbers or the other is data, number data or text data. Okay, so to write and run a Python program, if you want to write the Python program and if you want to run or execute the Python program, we need to have a Python interpreter that should be installed in our computer. Okay, so Python interpreter should be installed in our computer. So what is Python interpreter and what is the IDLE that I will show after explaining this paragraph? So IDLE, GUI integrated. GUI means what? Graphical User Interface integrated. That also I will show to you how it is said as GUI. So it is a standard and most popular Python development environment. If you want to develop a Python code in this environment, this IDLE environment is going to be used. So IDLE is an acronym of, that is a short form of Integrated Development Environment. So it is used for editing and running, browsing and debugging the Python programs from a single interface. That is a single place itself, we can do all these works together. So this environment makes it easy to write the programs. So Python programs, if you want to write, you can write it in a Python interpreter. So how this is going to be implemented, this Python IDLE is going to be installed in your computer. So we will be using a version of 2.7 or 3.7, it is going to be used now. So 3.8.5 is the latest one, now I have seen that. So we will be using version 2.7 of Python IDLE to develop and run the Python code in this course. It can be downloaded from www.python.org. See, now I am going to go to this website, how it can be downloaded. See here, www.python.org, you just typed in Google and you will get the first link as welcome to python.org. This is www.python.org website. Just click this website, it will go to that particular website. Okay, so here in this downloads, you just click. Okay, so in the download Python 3.8.5, this is the latest version for Windows. So if you are using Windows, Linux, Unix or Mac OS X and other OSs and all, you can go and click on this download Python. Okay, so it is getting downloaded here and it is going to be executed, installed here in your computer. Already I have Python. So now I'm going to close this. I'll show this continue downloading I gave. So let it continue its downloading process. So now I'm going to minimize this. Just I'll open how this Python shell, no? Ideal environment, how it is working, that I'll show now. See here, you need to open. Already I have Python 2.7 version also, 3.7 also. In this idle Python 3.7, 64-bit. This one you need to open. So this is opened here in this, that is GUI interface means what? So GUI means it will be having some menus like file, edit, shell, debug options, window, like that menus we will have. So with the help of menu, we can easily create a new file and we can open an existing file, okay? And we can save the file and we can exit from this window also. So all those things we can easily do it with the help of this graphical way. Okay, so graphically everything is available. So by clicking these icons and by clicking these menus and options, you know, commands under this menus, we can make use of, we can work with this Python idle environment in an easy way. So this way, if you are going, you know, this is known as script mode. So that means the entire program, you can type it here. If the program is having around 10 lines or 5 lines or more than 10 lines also, you can type it here and you can save it. Okay, you can save the program, no, with the .py extension. So it is going to be saved in the inside the Python version folder only. So where your software is located, in that folder inside, the name of the file, whatever you are typing, that will get saved. With .py extension only, all the Python files are going to be saved. See, automatically the save as type is displayed as Python files only. So if you just give the name and if you click on save, it will be saved with the default extension as what the file extension as .py only. Okay, so like that you can save the file also here. Okay, so now I just cancel that, and then I'm going to cancel this. So this way of executing, that is by clicking on file and new file, it will open a script mode. In that script mode, you can type, this is known as interactive mode. So here, just if I give 5 plus 6, okay, see here, 5, it's not typing, see, 5, and then you need to give space, and then you need to start typing 5 and plus 6, plus enter. So immediately the answer is printed here. So this is immediately if you are getting the result, or if you type wrongly also, you'll get wrong answer. Okay, see something we will type. So syntax error. So immediately can't assign to literal. So that means this is also literal. Literal means what? Constant value, and left side also constant value. We cannot assign any constant to another constant. If it is left side a variable, see for example, a is equal to 15 or 18, it can be assigned. Now if you give print A, or else just A alone you give, okay, and enter, 18 is getting displayed. So whatever you are giving in the Python prompt after, this is known as this three arrows, no, it is known as Python prompt. Okay, so three greater than symbols after only you need to type any commands. So this way of executing any coding is known as the interactive mode of execution. I think now you have clear about how to download the software, which website you need to go in order to download this Python interpreter for your computer. So if you are using Windows XP and lower of Windows XP 2.7, you can download Python 2.7 version. If it is more than that is Windows 7, 10 and all, you can download this 3.7 or 3.8 itself. Better you download 3.7. 64-bit version, okay, not 32-bit, 64-bit version only, it is suitable for Windows 10 OS and all. Okay, Windows 7 and Windows 10 OS and all, 64-bit version, it will be working nicely. Okay, next, Python shell can be used in two ways. So now I have explained about how the Python shell is working. So Python shell can be used in two ways. One is interactive mode and another one is script mode. Script mode means we need to type the program and we need to save it using .py extension. Where interactive mode, as the name suggests, whatever input we are giving, immediately we'll get a reply for that. So that is only known as interactive mode. So as the name suggests, it allows the users to interact with the OS, operating system. Script mode, it let us create and edit the Python source file. We can create the source file and we can edit the source file, but immediately we cannot run it. Okay, so for that we need to click on run command only. Okay, so now we will first start with interactive mode. Here we type the Python statement and the interpreter displays the results immediately. Now only I explain, after this Python prompt I have typed 6 plus 5, immediately afterwards I press enter, immediately it is showing the result. See, when we start the idle following window will appear. So like that only we got the window now. So for working in interactive mode, we will start Python on our computer. You can take the help of your teacher. Now only I explain how I have opened this Python shell. And in this, if you are typing, immediately you will get the results. So what we see is the welcome message of Python interpreter. See, this is only welcome message. See, this part only welcome message. Okay. So that is the Python version, okay, and which year it was released, which time, and whether it is 2-bit or 64-bit version, whether it is supported for which kind of processor, Intel processor or some other processor, and then a copyright information of this Python and credits, license information, and all. If you want to see, you can type this name and you can get the answer from your Python interpreter. See. It's a welcome message of Python interpreter with revision details and the Python prompt. So revision details, everything is there, which year it was released and all. And we can have the Python prompt after this. This is only known as, this three Clayton symbols only known as Python prompt. Okay, so this is the primary prompt. This is only primary prompt. Secondary prompt also we have. What is meant by prompt? Prompt means it is expecting something from user. So you need to enter some value for that. It is expecting something from you like that. The meaning is meaning for prompt is that is only. So this is the primary prompt indicating that the interpreter is expecting a Python command. So here this prompt is expecting what? Python command only. So there is a secondary prompt also, which is dot dot dot, indicated with the help of dot, three dots. Okay, that means the interpreter is waiting for the additional input to complete the current statement. For example, if you typed some command, you didn't complete that command properly, so that means dot 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 will appear. So you need to complete that command and then this dot, three dots will not get appear. So next, interpreter, it uses the prompt to indicate that is ready for the instruction. Okay, so that means it is ready for getting the command or getting the instruction. Instruction other name is what? Command. Okay, so therefore we can say if there is a prompt on screen, if you are getting the prompt on the screen, it means idle is working in an interactive mode. Okay, so we can type the Python expression. Now only I have typed 6 plus 5. It is an expression only with the literals. Okay, 6 is the literal constant value and 5 is also constant value. So 6 plus 5 I have typed, and then a is equal to 10 I have assigned. So that is also expression only. So wherever variable and literals which is involved with some operators like equal to or plus or minus, like that operators, if it is involved, that will make a expression. Okay, so expression or statement or command. Statement means what? Input, getting input. Int of input of enter a number. So like that, any statement if you are typing, that statements are also going to be, that statements also we can type it after the prompt and the Python immediately responds with the output of it. So if you type correctly, you'll get the correct output. If you type wrongly, previously I have typed wrongly, you know, like 77 is equal to 9 I have assigned, immediately it was showing like syntax error, we cannot assign literal to another literal. Okay, so let's start with typing print how are you after the prompt. So if you type like this, no, print how are you, immediately you'll get the answer. Let me show that print how are you also here. Okay, so go to this Python shell 3.7 idle 64-bit I have opened. So in that I am going to type just print, okay, within double quotes, how are you? Actually, here it will expect this parenthesis also because they have explained in your book. They have explained with the Python 2.7 version only in your book. Okay, so here I am explaining with 3.7. So in 3.7, without parenthesis, this print statement will not work. Okay, so how are you is printing. See, now without parenthesis, I will type now. So print after space, then single space after single space, and then double quotes you need to give because this is a string. Okay, string means what? It's a group of characters. So how are you is a group of characters only, group of letters only. Okay, just I'm typing like this without parenthesis. It is showing syntax error, missing parenthesis in call to print. Do you mean print parenthesis how are you? So it is indicating us with the answer also. Okay, so with the help of this error and indications, we can understand that where we have done the mistake and we can correct it immediately. Understood. So Python 3.7 versions always print statement, it should have the parenthesis followed by parenthesis. So whatever you are seeing in the book, according to the version, you need to understand and do it in your Python interpreter. So if you are using 2.7, it's not an issue. No need to use the parenthesis. But if you are using this 3.7 version, see here 3.7.3 still only I am using. So you need to type with it inside the parenthesis. So this smaller changes and all you need to understand when you are typing. So now print how are you have typed. Next, we need to do some following exercises and we will get the answers also. So print 5 plus 7. So print after 5 plus 7 we will give 12, it is printing. So we got the answer. Next is even 5 plus 7 also if you give, it will give the answer as 12 only. Next one, even without a print statement, it will show the result. Here, next to third exercise is 6 star 250 by 9. So here you need to understand one thing. You need to say, know the expression evaluation order. So that is division or multiplication need to be performed first. Here, division only need to be performed first because this is only having higher priority. Division and the priority table, if you study, you know, operator the precedence table, in that table, it is given like multiplication is having lesser priority than the division. That is, division is having more priority than multiplication. So we need to, even if the expression is having multiplication operator in the beginning, we need to solve the division first. So 250 by 9 is going to be solved first, and then that is going to be multiplied with 6. So let us see what is the result of 6 star 250 by 9 in the calculator. Okay, so calc software I am going to show to you. Okay. So calculator, I am just opening in order to know the answer of this. So 6 multiplication 250 by 9. So 166 it is showing. Okay. So let us see whether we are getting the same answer. Okay. Now Python cell we will go 6 star 250. 6 multiplication 250. So instead of multiplication, that this X symbol you should not type. You need to type this asterisk symbol, just present above that number 8. Okay, number 8 key, you need to press along with shift. Okay, in order to get that asterisk symbol. So 6 star 250, division 9 only, no? So division 9, press enter. So same answer only we have got in the calculator also. So you can cross verify with your answer. So how it is performed, 250 by 9, that is going to be multiplied with 6. So like that only the operation is going to be performed. Now next one, next example we will see from your book. So print 5 minus 7. So how we can type it here? Print, type correctly. So print, opening parenthesis, 5 minus 7, close the parenthesis, press enter. So minus 2. So minus 7 and plus 5. So what will be the answer? Minus 2 only the answer. Okay, now it is also possible to get a sequence of instructions executed through interpreter. So see here, this also we can, this entire program we can type it in interactive mode. See, this is a group of statements. X is equal to 2, Y is equal to 6. That is, addition of two numbers is performed and the result is printed here. So this we can do it in an interactive mode. And this also we can do it in interactive mode. And we will check how the same answer we are getting or not. Okay, so this can be done in the script mode also. That script mode also I will explain now after this, after explaining in interactive mode. So X is equal to 2, Y is equal to 6. X is equal to 2. So now X is assigned with 2, Y is assigned with 6. Z is equal to X plus Y, we will do X plus Y. Now print Z. Print inside Z we will give. Okay, so 8 is got, 8 is getting printed. Okay, so we got the answer, same answer. So next, this one we will perform. A is equal to 3. Now A is going to be incremented, that is A plus 1. So what is the answer after this A plus 1? 4. 3 will become 4. Now comma after A minus 1 we have done. So what is the A, latest A now? Sorry, in this statement what is the A? 3. Okay, so 3 minus 1, 2. So 4 and 2 is going to be printed in a tuple format. Tuple is one of the topic which you are going to study in this Python chapter only. Okay, so let us assign the value for A. So A is assigned with 3. Now a plus 1 comma a minus 1 we will give together and we will get answer as in the tuple format. That is 4 comma 2. It is displayed in the form of inside the parenthesis shape. Okay, so this is an example for tuple. Okay, and next one is, so result of hash, no, this hash is indicating hash after whatever we have typed. That is result is tuple of two values is given, no. So hash after whatever we are typing, that is going to be treated by the Python interpreter as a comment line only. So comment line is the line which is going to be understandable by the programmer or any user who is going to read the program. It is not going to be executed by the Python interpreter. It is just simply a immutable one, mute statement only. So it is not going to give any effect in the program's output. Okay, that is, it won't work in the it will not be executed in the Python interpreter. Okay, so it is a comment statement. We will talk about this comment statements. There are different types of comment statements are there, how we can give those comment statements, like multi-line, single line comment statements, like that many are there. So that we will see in the later chapters. So now we are good to write the small code on our own in Python. So this we have tried in the Python cell and we got the result also. While writing in Python, remember Python is a case sensitive one. That means capital X and small x are different in Python. That also we will check it here. So now already x is assigned with 2. Now this I am going to assign this capital X is assigned with 10. Okay, now I am going to print small x. Small x already assigned with what? See here, small x is already assigned with the 2 here. So this small x, what is going to print, we will see here. 2 only it is printing. Okay, so now capital X I am going to print. See here, 10 it is printing. So now you can understand that it is treating the letters, no, in smaller letter and upper letter is in a different way. So it is not treating in the same way. So Python is case sensitive or not? It is a case sensitive that you need to remember till you apply this Python, wherever you are applying this Python programming language, you need to remember this one, very very important one. Okay, so Python, it is a case sensitive one. That means uppercase and lowercase are going to be treated in a different form, different way. Okay, if we want to repeat the prior command, that is previous command, in an interactive window, you can use this upper arrow key or to scroll back through the commands history. So in order to go back to the commands history, you can use the upper arrow key in order to get back the commands. But here it is not coming. In command from black color screen, we will get that arrow key to scroll back through the commands history and down arrow key to scroll forward and use enter key to select it. After selecting the command which you want to get it in your screen, no, interactive mode screen, you need to use the enter key. After selection, you can use this arrow key, and for searching you can use this arrow key, and for selection you can use this enter key. Okay, so using these keys, your prior commands will be recalled and displayed, and we may edit and return them also, rerun also, not return. We can edit the coding also and we can rerun the coding also again. And if you want to come out of this interpreter, to leave this interpreter, we can use the control plus D or quite quit opening and closing parenthesis function, we can use it. And F6 will restart the cell. F6 also we can use for restarting the cell. Now I'm going to type quit. So it is going to be quitted. See here. So yes, your program is still running. You want to kill it. If you give OK, this will be closed immediately. Okay, so no need to give OK. So now, help of idle can be explored to know about the various menu options available for the programmer. So apart from writing simple commands, let's explore the interpreter more. Okay, so we need to type credits after the prompt, and what we get is information about the organization involved in Python development. Which organization is involved in Python development, you will understand by typing this credits. See here, credits, opening and closing parenthesis I am typing. So it is showing who and all involved in developing this Python code, that is displayed here. Next one is copyright and licenses command. No, if you type, no, we will know more about in Python also. Help command provides help on Python. It can be used as help also with nothing in parenthesis. Will allow us to enter an interactive help mode. Okay, so a name we need to use in a bracket. Okay, in a bracket inside, no, any name we can use, and it will give us a detailed of the referred word. So whatever referred word we are using inside the parenthesis related to that referred word, we will get the correct answers. Okay, so to leave the help mode and return back to interactive mode, quit command can be used. Okay, help mode, if you want to leave from the help mode and we want to return back to the interactive mode, we need to use the quit command again. Okay, so let us see that also. Let us help the quit, we will use it here. Okay, now we have left from this from this help, that is credits mode. Credits function out now, we came out. Now we are going to type the license information. Okay, now we want to get the license information about the Python. License, opening and closing parenthesis and press enter. So all the license information about this Python software you will able to see here. Okay, next also you can give quit. Okay, it is coming out. So we will close this, afterwards we'll open. Okay, so the screen size is very that is I cannot able to scroll down to see that command prompt, Python prompt, that's why I have closed that. So let us open one more time and we will see that. Okay, so script mode also I have explained already. In script mode, we can type the Python program in a file, okay, and then use the interpreter to execute the content from the file. So working in interactive mode is convenient for beginners. So if you are a beginner, just now I have explained how we can execute line by line code, and we got the result immediately after pressing the enter key in the keyboard. So and for testing small pieces of code, we can test them immediately in the pitch mode, interactive mode. But for coding more than few lines, if you are going more than few lines, 5 lines or 10 lines, we should always save our code so that we may modify and reuse the code. We can modify the code in future also, and we can reuse the code also. And then result produced by the interpreter in both the modes will be same only. So we won't get the different answers in a different modes. Interactive mode, what we got, no? Previously we have typed a x is equal to 6 something we have entered, and print z is equal to x plus y, we got 8 as answer, no? So that is not going to be 8 now, will be produced in the same interactive mode and script mode in the same manner only. So in order to open the script mode, no? See, Python in interactive mode is good enough to learn and experiment or explore, but it is only drawback is that main drawback is that we cannot save the statements for further use, and we have to retype all the statements to rerun them. So we need to type again in the interactive mode. That is a maximum drawback in this interactive mode. So to create and run a Python script, we will use the following steps in idle. If the script mode is not made available by default with idle environment, so we need to go for file and open or file new window in order to create a new script file and write the Python code as function, and then save it. Like a function we need to type and execute it in interactive mode by using run option F5 key. And after the execution, see here, the same coding I'm going to use it in the script mode. Let us open file new window. See, I'm going to open this in the same Python 3.7. Okay, so idle 64 bit I have opened. So in the file new file I have opened. So just paste this. Okay, see here, you need to see the indentation level also. See, I have pressed backspace key and press enter. See here, immediately you are able to see the 4 white spaces here. So from the margin, 4 white spaces are left in order to show that this is having some indentation. This statements are belongs to this test function. Test is the function name. Okay, so whenever any function name is return, that should be followed with the keyword def only. So def means definition of the function. So here this test is the function name. So always the function name will be indicated with the help of this opening and closing parenthesis at the end, colon. So function definition should be in this format only, that is def keyword after name of the function, opening and closing parenthesis. Parenthesis inside we can pass the parameters values also, but here we are not going to pass any values. So we have assigned the values here. Okay, in the same way, just bring all the statements in the same indentation level. Okay, So now, for all the four lines, we have given the same indentation level by giving by pressing backspace key and pressing enter. Okay, now I'm going to run this code. So before running the code, it will ask us to save the module, save the file. Source code must be saved, and we need to click OK in order to save this. Okay, so now just test file. So test.py we need to give in order to save. Whenever you are saving Python file, .py, save it. Missing parenthesis, because this is 3.7 version, no? So you need to give parenthesis. Okay. So again, we will run this code. Okay. So we have saved. So if your program code is correct, you will get the statement like this, restart. Where it is saved, where this test.py is got saved, it is saved inside this Python 337 folder. So now what we need to do here, we need to call that function. So test is the name of the function. Okay, you will get answer as 8. See, we got the answer. So we should not give colon here when we are running, when we are calling this program, or when we run the program now, execute this program now, just we need to type the function name followed by opening and closing parenthesis and just press the enter key in order to view the result. So if there is no error in your code, immediately you'll get the statement like this, restart. Okay, so in the same manner, you can also execute in your system after downloading this software. Okay, so now we will quit this editor, so interpreter. Yes. Okay, so now you understood how to save this file and how to always this should be saved with file, should be saved with .py extension. And after for execution, we need to press the F5 key, and we need to, we have typed like this in a interactive mode, and we got the result as 8. Okay, so we can choose run option also. While working in script mode, we add print statement in our program to see the results, which otherwise were displayed on the screen in an interactive mode. Even without print statement, it will get executed. It will get printed in an interactive mode without typing those print statements and all. So just if you give 5+7 and press enter key, immediately 12 will get printed without printing, without using the print statement. That is only they have mentioned here in this note. So in the next video, we will see variables and its types. Thank you for listening. And if you have any doubt, you can call to me. Thank you, students.